God.
She's crying.
Dearly beloved,
we are gathered here today
to witness
our debut as wedding officials.
For those of you who don't know us, you really ought to. My name is Jenny Perkins.
And my name is Stu Levick, but you can call me Father Levick.
Welcome to our wedding.
This is the first time we ever officiated a wedding, so we are very excited to be here. This is what we hope to be a start to a long and illustrious career of officiating weddings.
We have a great show for you tonight.
Steve's father, Dan, is here.
And Jamie's parents, Eileen and Byron, are here.
Kaylee, Julius, Teddy, and Mr. Mumbles were supposed to be here, but they cannot make it. They send their regards.
Dearly beloved, thank you to the friends and family that are here this evening to celebrate the union of Jamie and Steve.
This occasion not only marks the beginning of their marriage commitment together, but it is a commemoration of the love nurtured and shared between these two. Together they embark today on a new life together, built on the foundations of trust, compassion, mutual respect, and CrossFit.
For those of you who don't know the story how Jamie and Steve met, it's right out of the movies. Jamie moved into Center City, into a new condo building, and Steve lived across the hall. Now, if fate didn't step in, Steve would not have been Jamie's neighbor. In a last-minute switch, Steve negotiated to buy the condo that his sister Jackie found. Steve and Jamie were destined to meet and fall in love, and the rest, as they say, is history.
Steve and I met back in the late 80s through a mutual friend, Lane Dubin. Most friendships grow because of mutual interests, which at that time in our lives was alcohol and gambling. We were both at the tail end of our illustrious college careers, so we had plenty of time to enjoy each other's company and our interests. Quarter of a century later, not much has changed, except that we are both blessed to be in love with amazing women. I knew pretty quickly Jamie could be the one for Steve. They both have very similar personalities and enjoy many of the same things. They both love not to cook. They're pets and awful, awful television. If they can just nurture those qualities in each other, I know nothing can stop them.
I actually met Steve before I met Jamie. I decided to try a TRX class at the new gym that I joined. Steve completed each move with one hand and his eyes practically closed. I, on the other hand, vacillated between water breaks and jokes. TRX wasn't really my speed, so I moved on to Zumba. And that is where I met Jamie. Jamie was the first real friend that I made in Philadelphia and the best friend that I could ask for. Over the past few years, I have had the pleasure of watching Steve and Jamie's love story. They moved in together, threw parties together, traveled together, worked out together, drank cocktails together, bought a house together, tested hot tubs together, and raised a puppy together. Now, as Steve and Jamie embark on this new chapter in life, a little thing called marriage, I know that everyone in this room will be cheering them on.
As you may have guessed, Jamie and Steve are more of a modern bride and groom. Jenny and I spent several days reviewing the classic form of art that is typically expressed at weddings.
It's true, it's true.
19th century poem. While we both found some great treasures, we decided to share with you more contemporary expressions of love.
Besides Steve, one of the biggest loves of Jamie's life is music. Steve loves Jamie, so he listens to her amazing playlist for her spin classes. To that end, Stu and I have each picked lyrics from a song that we feel best express the love Jamie and Steve share for one another. I will start. Not only is this song arguably the theme of this wedding, it was written by Jamie's favorite musicians of all time. Love, love, love. Love, love, love. Love, love, love. There's nothing you can do that can't be done. Nothing you can sing that can't be sung. Nothing you can say, but you can learn how to play the game. It's easy. Nothing you can make that can't be made. No one you save that can't be saved. Nothing you can do, but you can learn how to be you in time. It's easy. All you need is love. all you need is love. All you need is love, love. Love is all you need. All you need is love. All you need is love, everybody.
All you need is love.
Love. Love is all you need. Love is all you need.
That was beautiful. From my reading today, I selected an excerpt from one of my favorite contemporary artists.
Oh, God.
This selection is from a portion of this song where a man is expressing his love and appreciation for his woman for all that she has done for him. I think it's really relevant to the way Steve loves Jamie. It's titled, "You're All I Need" by Method Man. Shorty, I'll be here for you anytime you need me. For real, girl. It's me, your world, believe me. Not make a man feel better than a woman. Queen with a crown, that be down for whatever. There are a few things that's forever, my lady. We can make war or make babies. Back when I was nothing, you made a brother feel like he was something. That's why I'm with you to this day, boo. No front. Even when the skies were gray, you would rub me on my back and say, baby, it'll be okay. Now that reeled to a brother like me, baby. I'm actually going to skip the next line. And I'm going to walk these dogs so we can live in a fat ass crib. Word, life. I'll give you a ring to be my wife. Just be there for me, and I'm going to make sure we be living in the effing lap of luxury. I'm realizing that you didn't have to get with me, but you did. Now I'm going all out, kid. And I got mad love to give. You my everything.
Thank you, Sue. What a sweet sentiment. Now that concludes the reading portions of our ceremony. Dearly beloved, now comes part of the ceremony where Sue and I take a break.
At this time, before proceeding with the ceremony, we invite the couple to share the vows they have written.
Steve, I have been waiting for this moment for 6 years, 4 months and 18 days, or to get even more specific, 2,332 days, but who's counting? I knew from the minute I met you that we had a connection I'd never felt before. Despite the fact that we were just friends, I found myself sharing things with you that I'd never shared with anyone, which I knew meant something special. Although in the beginning we had some rocky times, I knew I couldn't give up on us. I knew we were meant to be together and that it was not going to let it be any other way. And thankfully we realized that I was right, and I have been ever since. You truly are the most amazing person I've ever met. You're honest, genuine, kind and caring, smart, handsome and funny. You've enhanced my life in so many ways. You've taught me so much about myself and life in general. You've taught me the meaning of unconditional love, what it means to trust someone and know that they will always be by your side no matter what. You've given me the faith and confidence in myself that I can achieve anything. You made me realize that even after 6 years, 4 months and 18 days of being together, it's still possible to get butterflies in your stomach when you see someone. And most importantly, and the one that is probably the proudest moment for you, is you taught me you don't need to use a calculator and Excel at the same time. For the rest of our lives, I promise you a few things. I promise to recognize when you need space or time alone, and I'll give you at least 10 to 15 minutes without bothering you. I promise to listen to you even if it's about college basketball. I promise to not laugh when you cry at movies or stupid TV reality shows. I'm just kidding, I can't promise that. I promise to let you be you, to pick you up when you fall and always support you. I promise to be by your side and be your number one fan, to always be honest and faithful and be the best teammate you've ever had. In a quote your mom used to say, if you live to be 100, I want to live to be 100 minus one day, so I never have to live a day without you. I love you.
That I have absolutely no shot at getting through this without breaking down, but I'll do my best. Jamie, I will never forget the first night we hung out on my balcony. You asked me about my life, and after careful reflection said, I think it's going to take someone really special for you to get married. I remember laughing and saying sarcastically to you, I don't think so, I think I'll just marry the next person I meet. Well, it turns out we were both right. But you were way more right than me. It took someone incredibly special. I can't stand here and say that I knew at that moment that it was you, but I should have. I also remember after dancing around a relationship for a couple of years, when we both finally truly led each other into the other's heart. It was the most euphoric feeling and led to a whirlwind Memorial Day weekend together, meeting each other's families and friends. You've made my life better in so many ways, it's impossible to list. For the first time in my life, I feel settled, I have a real home, and I feel safe. And it's because of you. My only wish is that my mom would have had the chance to meet you. Not only would she have loved you, but all she ever wanted for me are all the things that you've given to me. I promise to always be there for you as your partner. I will always try to make you feel as safe and protected as you can feel. And I want to thank you for marrying me.
Jamie and Steve, your vows were beautiful and inspirational. Thank you for sharing
them. That sounded like a canned answer.
Thank you for sharing them with us all today. Now comes the legal part of the ceremony. Jenny, you're on.
Jamie, do you take Steve as your cherished husband in front of these witnesses and promise to stay by his side through sickness and health, joy and sorrow, so long as you both shall live?
Yep.
Steve, do you take Jamie as your cherished wife in front of these witnesses and promise to stay by her side through sickness and health, joy and sorrow, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
The wedding rings perfectly symbolize the never-ending love you two have for each other. By exchanging these rings, you solidify a lifelong commitment to one another. The rings serve as a welcome and constant reminder of the bond you've formed with your partner. Please repeat after me. I, Jamie, give you Steve.
I, Jamie, give you Steve.
This ring as a symbol of my enduring love.
This ring as a symbol of enduring love.
Just as the circle of the ring completes itself.
Just as the circle of the ring completes itself.
So you complete me.
So you complete me.
I, Steve, give you Jamie.
I, Steve, give you Jamie.
This ring as a symbol of my enduring love.
We gotta put it in the Excel spreadsheet.
Just as the circle of the ring completes itself.
Just as the circle of the ring completes itself.
So you complete me.
So you complete me.
Ceremony that Universal Life Church has taught us about. pretend like it's a challenge at CrossFit.
I gotta break this.
You gotta break it.
Jamie and Steve, by the power vested in us by the Universal Life Church and the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, we are pleased to pronounce you husband and wife, sealed today, both in law and in love. Steve, you may kiss the bride.
Husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Steve and Jamie Promislow.